When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
With a real live girl, straight off the farm, with an actual arm full of real live girl. Pardon me if your affectionate squeeze fogs up my goggles and buckles my knees. I'm simply drowned in the sight and the sound and the scent and the feel of a real live girl. Similes that have set my heart off in a whirl, but nothing can beat getting swept off your feet by a real live girl. Dreams in your bunk don't compare with a hunk of a real live girl. Speaking of miracles, this must be it. Just when I started to learn how to knit, I'm all in stitches from finding what riches are.
Maslon, your host today for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 FM, PeconicPublicBroadcasting.org. You may be wondering, well, we had Bob Goulet singing Real Live Girl. Is there going to be a Cy Coleman retrospective today? Well, if only there were, we really should do one. He's one of my favorite composers. But we're going to take that song from Little Me a little more literally. Nowadays on Broadway, there are two shows that feature real live people. There is a play about Judy Garland, starring this British actress named Tracy Bennett, and of course, a revival of Evita, starring Elena Roget from London. So we're going to look at literal real live girls, in other words, those heroines in Broadway musicals that are based on real life personalities. There are actually a fair amount. Many of them are historical figures, first ladies, or politicians, or people who change the world. And a lot of them are performers, obviously, because that befits the musical stage. So let's turn first to the latter. Funny Girl, the 1964 musical about Fanny Bryce, is perhaps the best of these musical stage biographies. So let's have a doubleheader. We'll hear first Fanny Bryce, upon whom the musical is based, of course, singing her indelible version of My Man, which she made popular in the 1922 Ziegfeld Follies. And then we'll hear Barbra Streisand recreating Fanny Brice. Now, some of you may not know that in the stage version of Funny Girl, they weren't allowed or they didn't want to use the real Fanny Brice songs that she made her career with. So Julie Stein and Bob Merrill wrote a group of analog songs. And unfortunately, in the movie, they didn't include this wonderful song, The Music That Makes Me Dance. I think it's a great 11 o'clock number and deserves to be here more often. So we shall. First Fanny Brice and then Barbara Streisand, celebrating the life of Fanny Brice.
Simple addition, then swear that the figures are lying. I'm a much better comic than mathematician, 'cause I'm better on stage than at intermission. And as far as the man is concerned, if I've been burned, I haven't when the sky and the ground started ringing. I know that he's near by the thunder I hear in advance. His words alone are the words that can start my heart singing. And his is the only music that makes me
We like to think of that great musical theater goddess, Ethel Merman, as being sort of inimitable. But she also played two real live girls in various musicals, both of which were written by Irving Berlin. The story goes that lyricist Dorothy Fields was in Coney Island and she saw a sharpshooting exhibit and she thought, oh, Annie Oakley is a musical and Ethel Merman is Annie Oakley. And eventually they got Ethel Merman to play Annie Oakley in Annie Get Your Gun. Score, however, done by Irving Berlin. And then about 6-7 years later, Howard Lindsay was sitting in by a poolside in a hotel in Colorado or Los Angeles, I forget where, and thought about doing a show for Merman and said, I should come up with the most American character I can think of. And Lindsay and Krauss came up with the character of Pearl Mesta, who wasn't a character, was a real person, ambassadress during the Truman era, and crafted a musical around her for Ethel Merman, again with a score by Irving Berlin called Call Me Madam. So we'll have a Merman double feature here. She plays not exactly Pearl Mesta in Call Me Madam, but a character called Sally Adams. And her opening number is one of the great introduction numbers of all time, The Hostess with the Mostess. But first, let's hear her as the real-life sharpshooter Annie Oakley in Annie Get Your Gun.
Oh, my mother was frightened by a shotgun, they say. That's why I'm such a wonderful shot. I'd be out in the cactus and I'd practice all day. And now tell me, what have I got? I'm quick on the trigger with targets not much bigger than a pinpoint. I'm number one, but my score with a feller is lower than a sailor. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. When I the pistol. I sparkle like a crystal. Yes, I shine like the morning sun. But I lose all my luster when with a bronco buster. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. With a gun, with a gun. No, you can't get a man with a gun. If I went to battle with someone's herd of cattle, you'd have steak when the job was done. But if I shot the herder, they'd holler bloody murder. And you can't shoot a male in the tail like a quail. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. If I shot a rabbit, some furrier would grab it for a coat that would warm someone. But you can shoot a lover and use him for a cover. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. The gals with umbrellas are always out with fellers in the rain or the blazing sun. But a man never trifles with gals who carry rifles. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. With a gun, with a gun. No, you can't get a man with a gun. A Tom, Dick, or Harry will build a house for Carrie when the preacher has made them one. But he can't build your houses with buckshot in his trousers. For a man may be hot, but he's not when he's shot. Oh, you can't get a man with a gun. I was born on 1,000 acres of Oklahoma land. Nothing grew on 1,000 acres, for it was gravel and sand. One day father started digging in a field, hoping to find some soil. He dug and he dug, and what do you think? Oil, oil, oil! The money rolled in and I rolled out with a fortune piled so high. Washington was my destination. And now, who am I? I'm the chosen party giver for the White House clientele. And they know that I deliver what it takes to make 'em gel. And in Washington, I'm known by one and all as the hostess with the mostess on the ball. They would go to Elsa Maxwell when they had an axe to grind. They could always grind their axe well at the party she designed. Now the hatchet grinders all prefer to call on the hostess with the mostess on the ball. I've a great big bar and good caviar, yes, the best that can be found, and a large amount in my bank account when election time comes round. If you're feeling presidential, you can make it, yes indeed. There are just 3 things essential. Let me tell you, all you need is an ounce of wisdom and a pound of gold. And the hostess with the mostess on the ball. Entertaining vodka drinkers is a job they give to me. Making nice guys out of stinkers seems to be my cup of tea. What they really need behind the iron wall is the hostess with the mostess on the ball. There's a book of regulations as to who sits next to who. But there might be complications when the blue blood's not so blue. So the the priestess with the leastest protocol. Is the hostess with the mostest on the ball. An ambassador has just reached the shore. He's a man of many loves. An important gent from the Orient to be handled with kid gloves. He can come and let his hair down, ooh, have the best time of his life. Even bring his new affair down, introduce her as his wife. But she mustn't leave her panties in the hall of the priestess with the leastess, nor the hostess with the mostess, with the mostess on the ball.
I'm a little stunned that Irving Berlin wrote a lyric about panties in the hall. Must have made him blush, but it makes us laugh, so it all comes out in the end. Call Me Madam by Irving Berlin with that real live girl, Pearl Mesta, sung by an even liver girl, Ethel Merman. The 1959 musical Gypsy is a kind of real-life girl trifecta because it deals with three real-life people. Obviously, Gypsy Rose Lee, but her sister June Havoc, who was originally June Hovick, and their mother Rose Hovick. So we're going to hear the real-life Sandra Church singing Let Me Entertain You as Gypsy Rose Lee, and then we're going to hear this very bizarre cut with the real, real, real Gypsy Rose Lee doing a sort of version of one of the routines she may have done in burlesque. So first we'll hear Sandra Church entertaining her audience as Gypsy Rose Lee, and then we'll hear the real live McCoy.
Let me make you smile. Let me do a few tricks, some old and then some new tricks. I'm very versatile. And if you're real good, I'll make you feel good. I want your spirits to climb. So let me entertain you, and we'll have a real good time. Yes, sir, we'll have a real good time.
so proud of me. She watched the scenes from the wings every single show. She said I was acting, really acting. Mother watched the stage door, too. She wanted to make sure I wouldn't meet the right kind of men. Those were the days of the stage door Johnny, a species that's now extinct. They sure kept the girls expensively groomed, perfumed, bejeweled, and beminked. Mother approved of Mr. Harris, a wealthy Wall Street broker, 72 if he was a day. Mother liked him because he had a lot of insurance, but it turned out he had more endurance than insurance. One night he invited me to a party in his penthouse apartment. There was champagne, caviar, music. There was only one thing lacking at that party, some other guests. That old roué chased me from pillar to post. When he finally cornered me near a pillar, I left him at the post. I said, "Listen, Mr. Harris, there's a lot you have to learn about a stripper. Only certain things make her unzip her zipper." When she hears the plaintive moan of a low-down saxophone, she'll show more than she'd care to show to just one man alone. But when some wolf advances with a rush, that's when a stripper starts to blush. Even Scotch and Paul Roger leave her quite blasé, and with jewels from Cartier, she's simply bored. If you want her to be awed, just whistle and applaud. That's when the lady is abroad. She's as modest as can be when she's in male company, but when the trumpets hit high C, she's Lady Chatterley. Although she'd strip in Macy's window for a fee, she's oh so sweet and tender. I said sweet and tender. She'd never, ever surrender. In privacy, no siree.
Well, did you ever wonder what Gypsy Rose Lee really sounded like? Now you know. Of course, we can't see her in the flesh, but we can hear her. Interesting, she talks about her mom at the beginning. Whether that was an affectation or not, I don't know. But, of course, her mother was the star of the musical Gypsy. Hello, I'm Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 FM. Today we're dealing with real live girls. I hope you've been enjoying our program, and indeed all of our programs. You can listen to them on a podcast at peconicpublicbroadcasting.org. We have almost 20 now. It's pretty exciting. And I hope you, if you're enjoying the show, can go to the website, maybe make a pledge to this wonderful station and keep this wonderful music on the air, which you don't really hear anywhere else. Okay, so we're going to go back to our real-life gal show. And our next performer is Julie Andrews. Julie Andrews has actually played four real live girls in one form or another. You don't really think of her that way, but of course there was Guinevere in Camelot, insofar as she was real. And she played Gertrude Lawrence in a film biography of her life called Star. But today we're turning to two Rodgers and Hammerstein heroines. The first, of course, is Maria von Trapp, whom Julie Andrews played in The Sound of Music. And the second is from a recording I like very much, a studio recording of The King and I, where she plays Anna Leonowens, who was the real-life Welsh governess who went to Siam to look after the king's children in The King and I. In that recording, she's paired very nicely with Ben Kingsley, and of course it's a role she was born to play. But first we'll hear a role that she did play, the real-life Maria von Trapp, facing the challenge of taking over a house with seven children in The Sound of Music.
This day be like, I wonder, what will my future be? be so exciting to be out in the world, to be free. My heart should be wildly rejoicing. Oh, what's the matter with me? I've always longed for adventure, to do the things I've never did. Now here I'm pacing adventure, then why am I so scared? A captain with 7 children, what's so fearsome about that? Oh, I must stop these doubts, all these worries. If I don't, I just know I'll turn back. I must dream of the things I am seeking. I am seeking the courage I lack. The courage to serve them with reliance. Face my mistakes without defiance. Show them I'm worthy, and while I show them, show me. So let them bring on all their problems. I'll do better than my best. I have confidence they'll put me to the test, but I'll make them see I have confidence in me. Somehow I will impress them. I will be firm but kind, and all those children, heaven bless them, they will look up to me and mind me. With each step I am more certain everything will turn out fine. I have confidence the world can all be mine. They'll have to agree I have confidence in me. I have confidence in sunshine. I have confidence in rain. That spring will come again. Besides which, you see, I have confidence in me. Strength doesn't lie in numbers. Strength doesn't lie in wealth. Strength lies in nights of peaceful slumbers. When you wake up, wake up! It tells me all I trust I leave my heart to. All I trust becomes my own. I have confidence in confidence alone. I have confidence in confidence alone. Besides which, you see, I have confidence in me. When I think of Tom, I think about a night when the earth smelled of summer, and the sky was streaked with white, and the soft mist of England was sleeping on a hill. I remember this, and I always will. There are new lovers now on the same silent hill, looking on the same blue sea. And I know Tom and I are a part of them all, and they're all a part of Tom and me. Hello, young lovers, whoever.
I've been in love like you. I know how it feels to have wings on your heels and to fly down a street in a trance. You fly down a street on a chance that you'll meet, and you meet not really by chance. Don't cry, young lovers, whatever you do. Don't cry because I'm alone. All of my memories are happy tonight. I've had a love of my own.
When we started our broadcast today on Real Live Girls, we started with Fanny Brice. And you might think that was the first musical stage biopic of a star, musical theater star of the 20s and 30s. It wasn't. A show that predated Funny Girl by a year was a show called Sophie, about the indomitable Sophie Tucker, the last of the Red Hot Mamas. And that had a score written by Steve Allen. Yes, the same Steve Arino from television was actually quite a good composer. He wrote, "This will be the start of something big." And he knew something about real-life personalities because he played Benny Goodman in the film of the Benny Goodman story. And he wrote the score to a musical called Sophie, about Sophie Tucker, starred a singer named Libby Steger. Didn't run very long. It was a huge flop. So we had to wait a year later to get Funny Girl. So we have a strange little bit of jujitsu coming up here. I'm going to cut and paste a four-song medley. We're going to hear the real Sophie Tucker singing Some of These Days. Then we're going to hear Libby Steger singing a song called I'll Show Them All from Sophie. Then we're going to hear Judy Garland and Steve Allen sing that same song from her TV show. And then we're going to hear the wonderful Isabel Keating sing Judy Garland in the musical The Boy from Oz. So we're going to have real Sophie Tucker, stage Sophie Tucker, real Judy Garland, stage Judy Garland. Are you with me? Have you fastened your seatbelts? Here we go. I think it'll be very interesting. Off with Sophie Tucker.
You're gonna be so lonely. You'll miss my hugging. You're gonna miss my kissing. You're gonna miss me, honey, when I'm far away. I feel so lonely for you only. 'Cause you know, honey, you've always had your way. Far away, I feel so lonely. Oh. 'cause you know, honey, you've always had your way. And when you leave me, you know it's gonna grieve me. Gonna miss your big fat mama, your mama, some of these days.
Now I make a vow to everyone, they'll give me praise some of these days. They're really gonna see this red hot mama play. I'll show them all, I'll let them watch my dust. I'm on my way, and there'll be hell to pay. The top I bust. Someday I'll win. Someday they'll crawl. I swear as God's my judge, I'll show them
everybody will understand, because all of us have been too criticized and told to get out of the business, whatever business it may be, and we're made to feel not very pretty and not very worthwhile and not very brave.
It's true, Judy. And when people come at you in that, from that point of view, sometimes the response is just to tell the world off, just to say, I'll show them all.
I'll show them all, I'll show them everyone, I'll do my damnedest now and make a vow to everyone, they'll give me praise some of these days. They're red hot mama blade. I'll show them all, I'll let them watch my dust. I'm on my way, and there'll be hell to pay. The top or bust. Someday I'll win. Someday they'll cry. Believe me when I say I'll show them all.
all I wanted was the dream, just like anybody else. I didn't want it pushed aside, forgotten on the shelf. I wanted laughs and lots of lovers and limitless wealth and just one to say you're better than anybody else. All I wanted was the time to obliterate my past. I didn't know how time can come and go so terribly fast. It's hard to lose it when you the dream that you dreamed was just too good to last. All I wanted was the time to obliterate my past. I didn't
was the very talented Isabel Keating channeling Judy Garland in the musical The Boy from Oz, singing one of Peter Allen's song. Tough act to follow, that Judy Garland, but Isabel Keating won a Tony nomination for that performance. Well done. We have another Judy Garland performance live on Broadway, a real live girl, Tracy Bennett, doing a show called End of the Rainbow, which is more of a play with music. And we'll see how that does. Anxious to see that. We're coming to the end of our Real Live Girl broadcast, and we're going to deal more on the political level now. First ladies and political figures are often attractive to musical theater writers. Michael John Lachuza wrote a musical, off-Broadway musical called First Lady Suite, and Alan J. Lerner and Leonard Bernstein probably win the bonanza for the most first ladies in a musical with 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. It's a flop, but it's got a wonderful score. And of course, now on Broadway, we have Evita, about the first lady of Argentina, who is fiery and difficult and passionate and manipulative, with a performance by Elena Roger, which is supposed to be astonishing. So to close out our broadcast, we're going to put two first ladies back to back. We're going to hear Elena Roger singing Buenos Aires from the London version of Evita in 2006, so that should excite you to go and buy your tickets for the Broadway version. But first, we're going to hear Patricia Rutledge as a much calmer first lady, Mrs. John Adams, asking a young charge to take care of the White House because it represents the best aspirations of the United States. So we'll close out with our two real live girls, Mrs. Abigail Adams and Eva Peron.
Thank you. someone makes off with a dream, the dream will be yours. Take care of this house. Be always on call. For this house is the
flesh, your meat, you shall have every breath in my body. Put me down for a lifetime of success. Give me credit, I find ways of paying. Rio! Just a little touch of, just a little touch of the quality.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, we'll catch up some other time.